Hey everybody, welcome back to the Optima Tax Show for people who owe. I'm Dave.
I'm Rosie Steele.
And Rosie's back. We're gonna talk about our advanced collections again. Rosie joined us last time to cover ROs. And I'm gonna ask you some questions, Rosie, about what an RO can specifically do when they get assigned a tax case. So let me ask you, what are some of the enforcement actions they could take that they have power to do if they have a case?
Well, they can issue liens, they can issue levies, and they can make your life really miserable.
Yeah, I agree that. And they have access to information how. I mean, what are they looking at when they get a case assigned? What are some of the things they will do to find out where you are, where you bank, and those kind of things?
They can issue summons to multiple banks in order to find out if you have an account with them and get as much records as they want in order to satisfy the tax debt.
So Rosie, they have the ability to hone in on that taxpayer, know what they drive, know where they live, know if they're getting work done in their home. These are conversations you probably had with revenue officers on taxpayers we're representing, is that correct?
Absolutely, they are very familiar with the neighborhood. They know what kind of house you have, what kind of car you have, and how you're living, if you're living above your means or not.
Great point. So if I am living above my means and I've had a revenue officer assigned, I want to probably be pretty careful about what I'm doing. And is that a time where I should seek professional help?
Absolutely. If you are a little bit concerned about how you can move forward with your case, then I would absolutely reach out for someone for help.
At least for advice, right?
Yes.
And so let's assume I ignored the revenue officer notice that knocks on the door, the levies didn't hit my bank account, I'm able to hide some funds and not really feel the pain of a revenue officer enforcement or collection. What would happen next? What options did the revenue officer have?
Well, the revenue officer can issue a summons in order for you to appear in front of a judge at court.
Oh, wow. So that's a place, a dark place you don't want to do. Now we're talking some consequences,
yes,
even beyond financial, right?
Absolutely. You can have some big troubles moving forward just civilly, yes.
So Rosie, everybody wants to know, what are these revenue officers like? What are they dressed like? What can I expect if one's knocking on my door?
Well, they're very professional. This is what they do. This is their job. And just like anybody's job, they're human. They have to follow rules. They make errors, but at the same time, they will work with you in order to resolve your case.
I think the theme is, and you've seen the ads out there, black suits, black glasses, black hats knocking on the door. Is that happening?
It's not that intimidating. It's just scary when you know someone's coming to you for something that you owe, you know?
It makes a lot of sense. So as we said earlier, guys, it's better to engage with the IRS before they engage with you. Time is not on your side if you owe tax debt, especially if you have a revenue officer assigned, I'm assuming. We're at the extreme end of the tax collection cycle. It's a place you probably don't want to be. You want to know where you're at, more importantly, download our tax app so you can find out. Rosie, any parting words for folks who may be in this category?
Make sure you do something, especially if a revenue officer is assigned. Time is not on your side.
Thank you very much. Well said. We'll see you next time, everybody. Thank you for joining us today. Hey everyone, thank you for joining us. Be sure to like
and subscribe
to all of our YouTube videos. And if you need more information on Optima Tax Relief, please go to our website, OptimaTaxRelief.com.